So taking a look at the BrotherHobby R3 1106 7100 KV. As usual for this KV, this test, we'll be looking at it on 2S, and we'll be comparing it against the Emax 1106 4500 on 3S. Right away, we can kind of see what we saw when we did the thrust test. There's actually a lot of low efficiency. The low efficiency bands push pretty far up in the motor's performance range, and its area of peak efficiency definitely seems to tend a little more on the lower side than the other motors we've looked at so far. It's still fairly well matched for the 3-inch and 2.5-inch, although if anything, it's looking a little better on the 2.5 compared to our previous ones. You also have to say that the 2-inch loading down there probably is in a pretty good place for it as well. This peak efficiency is going to extend out a little further up there, and at very high RPM will be hitting that a lot more fully. So if you're running this on 3S, say, you might be in a better situation running a very light load at higher voltage, since that's where its best efficiency really is. If we compare across to the our kind of benchmark Emax, you can see just how dramatic that loss of efficiency is. Our peak efficiency isn't that much different. We still down in this range, we still are in the same performance band, but the zone of best efficiency is certainly much smaller, and we drop below 50% quite quickly, where on our Emax reference here, down to 50% covers a lot more of our usable torque range on the props compared to what we're getting out of the BrotherHobby. And toggling between them, you can also see the position and angle of this 100% throttle line, which shows us the other thing that we saw on the thrust stand there. This is a little anemic in power. We're getting lower thrust out of basically all of these props compared to the 4500, which really should be pretty comparable. If you remember how the 4500 on 3S compared with the 7500 on the same line, this is definitely weaker. If anything, the kind of peak numbers that we're seeing on here are a lot closer to the Emax 6000 KV. We can see that a little more clearly here. If we look at the actual trace for the 100% line, this lower one is this BrotherHobby motor, and the top one is our reference Emax. The 3040T is still really high power on the Emax. This is up in 140 watt range, and down on the BrotherHobby, we're looking at about 110 watts. So definitely lower peak power because of this, how much slower it's spinning here, just from the lack of torque to keep up. On our sort of 3-inch bi-blade range of props, where we're getting 95 watts on the Emax, the BrotherHobby is only pulling about 81 watts, so about a 15 watt difference in peak draw between those. And then down on our 2.5s, the BrotherHobby is giving us about 65 watts versus 67 on our comparison motor. So the gap is certainly closing up a little bit there, and the difference in thrust on the 2.5-inch is probably less than 30 grams, where if you compare on the 3040T, the difference is more like 55 grams of thrust. So a much bigger difference here as the loading increases. The gap closes as the load gets less, and you could certainly expect that somewhere down here below this, the DYS 2030 loading, if you had a lighter load than that, even with its general lack of torque, this BrotherHobby could definitely take the lead, where it doesn't require as much torque, but it has a little extra KV to make up. But for any other prop load, it's just not holding up. And the angle that torque curve is giving us here, how much shallower this is compared to the much steeper line here. Despite the KV, whatever is going on with the construction here, we're definitely lacking in torque compared to what Emax has been able to do. Good thing though is, at least at these sort of power levels, while this is a shallower torque curve, it doesn't seem to be falling off particularly fast up at the top. So while we don't have a ton of torque here, it doesn't look like we're hitting into saturation. at least at these load levels. So we're not getting the torque that we really want out of the motor, but it doesn't mean that the motor is at the end of its capability. There's certainly more torque to be had, as you crank the voltage up and force it to spin faster, although that's going to come at a bigger and bigger hit to efficiency.